Hi there, Tim Wilhelm here with a brief tutorial on knife sharpening intended to help newbies and novices get their blade shaving sharp. The knife I'll be using is a Finnish-made pukko with a blade made from what's called silver steel. Doesn't have any silver in it, but it is a fairly popular tool steel, good quality tool steel, used by bladesmiths over in Europe. Now, how do I know this guy needs to be sharpened? Two tests. One is the shaving test. So I'm going to take this blade and I'm going to drag it over my hair-covered arm like this, and I am not getting a single bit of hair off of there. The next thing is the paper whittling test. With a good sharp knife, I should be able to easily slice off thin, curly wafers of paper. But with this knife, unless I catch it just right, I'm mostly just tearing the paper like this. Now, before we dive headlong into the knife sharpening process, let's back up for the benefit of the newbies and take a look at a few basic fundamental principles underlying the process of sharpening all edge cutting tools. As a natural byproduct of the sharpening process, swarf can be an issue. Swarf, again, being the particulate matter taken off of the softer steel by the harder hone. If I'm working on a dry hone, that swarf will fill in all of the voids and pockets in between the bits of grit, and eventually it will fill up the voids between the grit and level it off with nothing but metal, thereby removing the grit of the stone and rendering it useless for sharpening thereafter. This is why we use honing oil. We put a wee bit of honing oil on the stone, and the purpose of the oil is not to lubricate the stone against the movement of the blade. The purpose of the oil is to float the swarf out of the voids between the grit, thus keeping the stone clean, keeping the grit integrity there, and not ruining your sharpening stone. Grit is the relative smoothness or roughness of your sharpening stone. If you have an edge like this that needs to be reworked because it's pretty flattened out and has chips in it, you would start with a coarse stone. Coarse is somewhere around 100 to 120 grit. If you don't need to reform the edge, you just need to kind of tighten it up a little bit, you would go first with a medium and then onto your fine. If you just need to touch it up, you go with a fine stone and only, and fine is somewhere around 600 to 800 grit. Then to polish it or strop it, you use 1,000 grit or more. Most blade edges are double beveled. They're beveled like this. That would be a single bevel. That's a double bevel. The sharpening angle is from the center line of the blade rotated out to the ground surface of the beveled edge. That's the sharpening angle. So if I have an angle of 20 degrees sharpening angle, the total angle of the blade is 40 degrees from ground surface to ground surface. Now, the reason that understanding angle of sharpening is important is because the narrower the sharpening angle, the more easily it will slice, but the less durable the edge. The greater the sharpening angle, the little harder it is to slice, but the more durable the edge. I like to bias toward the low side of that angle for outdoor knives. I typically try to go 20 to 22 degrees. It makes it a little easier for slicing, and so what if I have to sharpen just a little bit more often? That's sharpening angle. So the mission is clear. Turn this flattened apex, this very long, narrow rectangle, into a long, very narrow straight line at a given fixed angle. The challenge in this is that many people, myself included, have a hard time from stroke to stroke making the angle exactly the same each time. If you don't, your angle changes like this, you end up with sort of a rounded apex on the end of your knife. Not so good. So what I do to keep the angle consistent is use a sharpening jig. Let's set up and we'll start the sharpening process.
So I have my knife mounted into a sharpening jig. Nothing special about this one from Smith's. Very similar ones come from Gatco or DMT. One's just as good as another. Now, because this blade was pretty dull and had some chips in it, some little dings, I'm starting with a coarse stone. Coarse stones, and notice I'm putting honing oil on the stone. Coarse stones, I will typically take about 5 to 10 strokes per side before I flip over to the other side of the stone. And when I move to the fine stone, I'll only do like maybe 2 or 3 strokes per side. So I want to always make sure I don't hold the jig, I hold the knife. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the bottom slot, which will be a little sharper angle. And I'm going to hold both the hone and the knife. And here's the process. You go forward across the hone as if you're slicing off a thin layer. And you do that not with tons of pressure. Let the stone do its work. This is keeping a nice consistent angle. And I'm going to do this about 7 to 10 strokes per side. I can change sides. Then I come back like this, but I'm still slicing off, like I'm slicing a thin layer of this, and I'm going to keep this up until I see a noticeable amount of swarf. I've switched to a fine stone, less aggressive, fewer strokes per side, but again, the technique is the same. Hold the knife, hold the stone, and try to slice thin layers off of the stone with the knife blade, not tons of pressure. I need one more step here. It's called stropping. I can feel a very light burr of folded over metal at that very ultra thin edge of the blade, and I need to remove that. I use a leather stropping block into which I have rubbed green chromium oxide compound. Now, stropping, different than sharpening, instead of pushing like this, I'm going to back blade. And I'm going to go a little bit steeper angle than the angle that I sharpened at. So I put the blade down and I pull back. Put the blade down and I pull back. Pull back. And notice I'm not running it perpendicular like this. I'm kind of going lengthwise with the blade like this. That will remove the burr and make the knife about as sharp as it can possibly be. Now it's time to see how well we did. Let's try to whittle some paper, but first watch this little test. Try that with your kitchen knife at home. Now let's see what kind of small, tiny curls we can get off of this guy. Last but not least is the shaving test. I take no responsibility for people cutting themselves, but just like shaving your face, I'm going to put the blade down here and holy cow, smooth as a baby's behind. And I'm getting all kinds of hair off of there. What that means is sharpening success. Good luck, have fun, and be safe.